Mike, Your Excellency President Aliyev, distinguished leaders of international organizations, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor to participate once again in this World Forum on Intercultural Dialogue, a valuable tradition that we at UNESCO are proud to have been associated with since the very early days. Our presence here today is a testament to the vision and commitment of President Aliyev and the government of Azerbaijan in their determined leadership to promote intercultural dialogue and the mutual understanding that the Baku process puts forward. The process was launched just over 10 years ago, as you have heard, and the vision to place intercultural dialogue at the heart of the international agenda has had an enduring relevance. We have come a long way, and we have evolved together. This time, the concept behind the forum is also about our ability to focus, and I think we can show that less will be more, to aim for coherent structures and debates so that we can follow up with concrete action. This is indeed the idea behind this fifth edition, mobilizing a vision with renewed spirit of innovation to ensure continuity and impact. And we are privileged that UNESCO has worked very closely with the government of Azerbaijan on this preparatory process, underpinning a strong core commitment that we share very deeply. These times certainly call for passionate engagement and proactivism. We see new forces of division emerging, spreading hatred, inciting fear, intolerance, and ignorance. We face pushback on the fundamental freedoms, on our normative standards, on our values, as we witness the very retreat of shame. We see conflicts continuing to tear societies apart with the rise of violent conflicts, polarization, and what seems to be a return of expressions of hatred that we thought we had long overcome. All this, of course, as the world faces the largest refugee and displacement crisis of recent history, at a time when cultural diversity is under threat from the pressures of exclusive populism. In the words of our Secretary General Guterres, and I quote, "Most disturbingly, we hear troubling, hateful echoes of eras long past and noxious views moving into the mainstream." Today's challenges are complex and they cross borders. They leave no room for unilateralism, complacency, or exclusion. Our goal must be to embrace positive transformations on the basis of human rights and mutual respect, not just tolerance, but also empathy, to shape it in positive directions, to craft a future that is more just, inclusive, and sustainable for all. This is the vision of the Sustainable Development Goals and what lies at the heart of the promise to leave no one behind. For all of this, we believe dialogue is key to show that diversity is and has always been a source of strength, and to empower individuals and societies alike that make the most of this reality for the benefit of all. This idea is at the heart of UNESCO's mission to build the defenses of peace in the minds of women and men. It guides all of our activities and partnerships, including with many of the organizations represented at this forum. This is why we are proud to lead the United Nations International Decade for the Rapprochement of Cultures, under which all our dialogue activities have been undertaking since 2013. This decade comes to an end in 2022, and we have already begun to take stock of what has been achieved and where we want to channel the momentum. What should happen after the decade? This is a unique opportunity to envisage an entirely new initiative, we hope, based on the wealth of experience that has gathered over the years, including through the Baku process and all of its stakeholders. This is also why we tirelessly protect the right to education, for example, at UNESCO, as a fundamental human right, understanding how essential it is to the empowerment of women and men, as it tackles the very processes that can lead to violent extremism by undermining prejudice, by fighting ignorance and indifference. In this same spirit, our work on citizenship education equips learners with skills and behaviors to reap the benefits of the world's growing diversity on the basis of moral and intellectual solidarity. It is underpinned by support to teachers, on a positive note, in promoting peace in classrooms and by bolstering media literacy with young people to prevent radicalization over the internet, as we impart the knowledge, skills and practices that allow effective access, analysis and critical thought and evaluation of information and media. Through all of these initiatives, intercultural dialogue runs as a connecting thread. However, much remains unknown about what needs to be put in place to make this dialogue effective. How should we measure it and be able to create the evidence for its mobilization as a tool for sustaining peace? This is the journey that UNESCO is currently undertaking through our initiative to measure the enabling environment of intercultural dialogue. And this is the core aspiration of the Baku Forum, that we should co-create, mobilize jointly to better understand and leverage more effective and impactful dialogue. Ladies and gentlemen, if we are here today, then we are heeding the call of Baku, because we understand the imperative for action. This fast-paced global transformation, social, economic, political, environmental, requires that we step up and respond with relevance, sustainability, agility, and courage. It is our hope that we will continue to work together to find ways to promote meaningful dialogue in order to understand our differences, reinforce and elevate our common values, and harness synergies for the common good. UNESCO will, we commit, do our part, and we look forward to this continuing collaboration. Thank you, Your Excellency.